Let's see what you have there. Put it on the counter and we'll see what has Clayton all worried. Interesting. Felt right. Okay, I need to run tests on this. Might take some time. But you also look interesting. There's something different about you. Best I take a closer look at you, too. Interesting. Very interesting. You got all those little computers racing around inside you. Secrets, secrets. Everyone's got a little secret. And you must be one big little secret. Haven't met one of you for a long time. Since working with the authority up in the city. You don't know how lucky you are that the authority hasn't found you yet. If the authority catches you and you don't have anything they need, you'll be dead. You are part of the old world, not part of their new world. Of course, there are people who stand up against them. Not many of them. They call themselves the Resistance. Not that I profess to have any special knowledge of them. But they exist in small bands, fighting back. And maybe, just maybe, you could be useful to them. You survived this long. You must have some survival skills worth using. But you aren't going to last long in a firefight against the authority with that standard defibrillator in your chest. I can give you an upgrade for it, something that might keep you alive longer. But that will require a little effort on your part. You see, I don't have the necessary equipment here. But you can find what you need in the Dead City. A well-named place, as you will soon see. In the middle of the city is a hospital. One I was proud to work in. Until the research took a decidedly twisted turn. I didn't see everything that was done there, but I heard the rumors. Now it's surrounded by a tremendous wall, filled with living memories of the horrors committed there. Going there and getting back won't be easy. But without an upgraded defib, you won't last another week here. I'd say, you have no choice. The hospital is in the middle of the city. Let's go.
Who the bloody hell?
Get back! I'm heading back!